NCD Noodles, the podcast. You hear me?
We back, baby. Smoking sports, man. Cool CD and Noodles back, man. We got some cool topics this week. We pretty much gonna get right into it, man. They got the NFL schedule. That draft just happened. That schedule just come out. We got the champs playing the Cowboys, man. What the Cowboys called, brother? America's team America's or something. Team. Yeah, you know.
You got America's team.
You got a lot of Cowboys.
I got Dallas winning the game. Easy. I got Dallas, baby.
Yeah, he come on. He just start the show with the foolishness. Man, come on, man. How you got these people just winning? These people just won a Super Bowl and nigga just gonna come beat them easy.
Yeah, man, we ain't tripping, bro. Time is over with. This the year he go down. 6-10. I'm just playing, y'all.
Yeah.
6-10. Y'all know
he's
6-10.
But
look,
9-7.
Tom Brady. 9-7
this year. He went to the bowl last year and he had Drew Brees in his conference. Drew Brees out of his conference now.
Now you got James.
Yeah, Drew Brees beat the piss out of one good time. But
Sean Payton beat him.
I feel that. I'm just saying how it looked.
But Dak, I'm back to that first game we was talking about.
Yeah, first game, man. Bucks and Cowboys. I mean, I think first game, that should be a tough one. Both of them got the talent.
Oh, yeah, I just was talking shit.
Both of them got the talent for sure. I know Dallas going to come. I think they're going to come to play, man. I think Dak should be ready, right?
Dak should be ready.
I think Dak going to be ready.
I seen the video. Because
Dak got hurt early on.
Video with Dak running around. Dak ready. Dak just was his ankle.
Right. Mm-hmm. Dak should be straight. Dak shouldn't going to be there.
And he got Amari Cooper. But they got that young boy, man, out Penn State, running 4-3 linebacker, stud in the middle. Michael Parsons from Penn State. They got him one for 10 years now in the middle. You know they already had studs. They got both of their linebackers' name, man. Dallas linebackers, but Dallas got a good linebacker core. But they just added they Ray Lewis in the middle.
I gotta see Dallas, man.
Dallas picked up a Louisiana native. Shout out to the guy that transferred from LSU to Kentucky. He went to Scotlandville High. Can't think of his name offhand, but he gonna start in Dallas. Shout out to him. Cause them young boys went up there and took his spot in LSU. He went started up there as a true freshman, was starting as a sophomore, then the young guys come up there when he was a junior and he was starting to lose a little tick, and he transferred to Kentucky, made all SEC, everything, picked up by Dallas in the second round. Yeah, shout out to that guy.
Wish we had his name on point. Shout him out, but yeah, man, that season getting gone, man. This drafting happened. We got Minnesota playing that Cincy first week. Hopefully Joe Burrow back. You'll have Joe Burrow, Jamar Chase, and Jordan Jefferson on the same field first week. Shout out LSU, baby, you know. But that'll be a nice game. Hopefully Joe Burrow back, man. I love Joe Burrow, bro. I feel like Joe Burrow gonna be the best quarterback in the league. He's gonna be able to say that down the line. In a few years, I don't know, it may be 5 years, maybe 3 years, maybe 7 years, I feel like he gonna get up there.
Shit, I got a bold prediction with Joe Burrow. If Joe Burrow played all 17 games this year, he a 5,000-yard passer. Joe Burrow can throw for 5,000 yards with the weapons he has. With the weapons he have right now, with the running back, you have to respect that box That boy, they forgetting, see, Joe Burrow got a stud behind him. You have to respect that running game. He's top five in the league when you ask anybody because he's healthy. He never been hurt, none of that. You know what I'm saying? He a stud.
Well, he stay hurt.
No, I'm talking about he never tore the knee or nothing, really. He stayed with the knick-knack injuries, you know, hamstring. He out this week. Yeah, he ain't never, he healthy, though, like, you know. He ain't never break nothing.
He still on the field, but he is, man, Joe Burrow, Jamar Chase, man. My bold prediction would be Jamar Chase. I say he come out and do Randy Moss numbers.
Man, he said that on the draft day. When you pull it up, Jamar Chase already said, I'm going to Cincinnati and break all their records.
Yeah, I saw him.
He said it.
Yeah, he said it.
Out his mouth.
He said it. The boy could play, man.
And you know, Chad called him on the phone. I seen the video when Chad called him. He was talking to Chad, like, Chad going to show him them routes.
Yeah, Chad got that orthodox footwork.
Chad special with teaching the routes and the footwork. And you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
So he's going in good hands. They love Chad in Cincinnati.
Man, Jamar Chase, man, big old body, fast, hands.
He really could do everything, man. Chase a stud, man. Chase a stud.
Burrow got the mind.
Chase is stud, IQ. Boy.
You feel me? What else we got first week, man? We got Chicago at the Rams, bro, with Matthew Stafford, and it's Justin Fields going to start day one. You know what I'm saying?
I wouldn't start him day one, not against them.
Yeah, you're going to feel the NFL right bright and early.
Real quick, we can't start you against them.
Right bright and early. Aaron Donald, defensive player.
We can't start you against them. And the dog more ready than you to play them people week one.
Yeah.
You know, I love Justin Fields. He going to be all right. He ain't ready to play against the Rams week one.
But look, he may have to, though.
He get outside that pocket and the dog, you know, he'll stand in statue. You know. It's a good game.
I think that's a nice game. I think that's a nice game
because it's going to be closer than what you think. The Bears will keep that defense. The Bears going to keep that defense, you know.
And the Bears got an offensive mind that coach. Now, Magnum, you never know, you know. The Bears, right? Don't they got the...
Magny, whatever his name is. They say he this offensive genius, but I ain't seen nothing yet. They say he is...
Mitchell Trubisky, man.
And they said that was the owner pick. They said that he was an owner's pick. Like, none of the coaches co-signed him out in North Carolina. He was a straight owner pick. The owner said, we going with him.
Then we got Cleveland Browns at Kansas City Chiefs.
That's my game of the week, week one. Over that's going to be a better game than Dallas-Tampa.
That's a tough game
right KC Chiefs, I'm rolling with KC first week. I mean, Cleveland Browns first week. It's going to be a repeat of what happened to them in the Super Bowl, but they're going to get it together throughout the season. But that new line ain't going to be ready for this line that's coming week one. Garrett and Clowney coming. With that young stud in the middle. They're going to get to Kansas City. They're going to run it.
That's going to be a tough game, man.
And they're going to run it down Kansas City.
Cleveland got the remedy to beat
anybody.
A high-paced offense. They can run the ball, play defense. Run the ball, play defense. With a solid quarterback. With weapons. So if they need to score, they should be able to. You know, I don't even know if it's arguably. They got the best running game in the league.
They have the best running game in the league. They have two guys that led the league in rushing before.
Yeah.
We know what happened with Kareem Hunt. You know, things happened. Shout out to Kareem Hunt. Turned everything around, and things turned out for the better.
Yeah, they're going to be tough. Cleveland going to be tough in the AFC.
They have two starters in their backfield.
They're going to be tough. They're going to be hard to beat.
Yeah. That's why I say even though we say what division that is right now is so tough, the NFC West, but I feel like it is one division that can challenge the NFC West for the best division in football, and that's the AFC North, bro. Cleveland. We know what Pittsburgh bringing.
Baltimore.
Lamar. Joe Burrow just come. Who gonna come in last?
I mean, of course they're going to pick Cincy right now. But
Baltimore, nah, this could Pittsburgh. Be a year Pittsburgh fall off. This could really be a year Pittsburgh coming last in the division. Because they got the less talent in the division. I'm going to keep it real. They got the D. They got studs on their D. But on paper, they got the less talent in the division.
When Pittsburgh had a losing record.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying.
I don't think Mike Tomlin had a losing record yet. I don't even think he did.
No, his worst record was 9-7.
Like, come on, man. Like, so he didn't win 9-7. Saying he had a worst record is still like, well, damn.
Yeah, but I'm looking at these teams this year in their division. I said, I'm not picking it to happen. It's a possibility, bro. The division that good that, you know, Pittsburgh could fuck around and not go to the playoffs, dog. They got talent in that division. And then according to who they play outside the division, that matter too.
Yeah, because I didn't get a chance to look at the schedule so deep and figure it out. But that bring me to the home team, the Saints. Me looking at their schedule right quick, briefly, because they just put the schedule out like yesterday or something. And I felt like we in a good position.
Yeah, we in a good position.
The Saints. We play AFC North.
We play the NFC East. We play Dallas Division.
We play Dallas Division, so we play now, and we play Buffalo, the Patriots, Miami, and
The Jets. We play them too.
I mean,
and we play Dallas, Philly, and Washington.
Yeah, and like. I don't think we scared of none of them.
Them teams hungry.
None, you know.
That's what the scary part is, see?
I'd rather a hungry team than a good team. No, but
them teams got talent.
Everybody got talent. Fuck. But which one would you rather play?
No, but I'm telling you.
I'd rather play Washington for sure.
No, but I'm going to tell
you. I'd rather play Philly for sure. I'd rather,
check this out.
I'd rather play Miami for sure.
No, you don't rather play Miami. Miami got the number 5 defense in the fucking league. That's what I'm saying. All them teams we saying, they're not good offensive teams. All them fucking teams we got to play, they got defenses.
That's cool.
They got defense, so that's why we got to play them this week. And we got to go play this another defense next week.
I'd rather play a good defense than a good offense in the regular season any day, because it's an easy game to win, but you put up a couple points, you ain't got the capability to score on me, cool. Like, do I rather play Kyler Murray or Miami? Just threat-wise. I'd rather play Miami because I know Kyler Murray can motherfucking just do some shit.
I think
make it a game, score 30 points, not expecting it, win the game. I don't expect Miami to do that. I expect Miami to grind it out and trying to beat it.
This that year right now.
Not trying to knock Miami though. I know Miami good.
Yeah.
They got a good ass defense.
It's not about to be you want to see Miami.
Yeah, man, if I had to pick.
It's not about
if we going off last year, what they got this year in the division they're in, I think all I'm saying is we playing a weaker division than playing the AFC West.
Yeah.
Yeah, what you mean? So you want Miami or you want Baltimore?
That's the North. The North is the AFC North with Baltimore. The West is Kansas City and the Chargers.
Well, what Patriots the is? AFC East. What? East, all right. You rather the East than the North.
Yeah, for sure.
So that's what I'm saying.
Because if we had to play Cleveland, Baltimore, Pittsburgh, Cincinnati.
Come on, what you mean?
Matter of fact, we played that division last year.
We played that division.
We played Cleveland, Cincinnati, we played Baltimore. And we played Pittsburgh. Pittsburgh, the only one we didn't play. We went to Lamar them and beat them.
Yeah, I think we played Pittsburgh, though.
Yeah.
I think we played Pittsburgh last year.
But,
so, that's some good games week one. NFL-wise.
Another matchup week one, man. Carolina versus the Jets. Bright and early, first week. He versus his old team, Sam Darnold.
Garbage bull.
No.
Garbage bull.
No.
For sure.
No.
How?
Carolina is good.
Man.
Carolina got talent, bro.
If they good, who?
Carolina good.
If they good, what the Saints is? The Saints good too.
Yeah, the Saints good too.
But so Carolina can't be good.
Carolina ain't garbage, dude.
Man, the Jets and Carolina first week garbage bull.
They're not on the same level. Carolina, the Jets on the Carolina on a little bit better tier than the Jets, bro.
They is.
Carolina got talent, DJ more than them dudes out there, dog.
Nobody's gonna be watching that game.
A guy you fuck with, McCaffrey.
Yeah, he the best nigga on the field. That's what I'm trying. Well, he a white boy,
come on, you gotta respect that. If Sam Darnold give him anything, they're a problem. It's all on what Sam Darnold do, because they got everything else. Dante Jackson, them locking up. Saying, first they got week, these stud corners.
I'm not saying Carolina can't come out and be a good team.
I know what you're saying. You ain't cutting that game on.
Yeah, we ain't watching that.
What the score is in that game.
Sam Darnold threw a 2 touchdowns. All right. McCaffrey 150 yards. Yeah, I ain't see a yard carry that game, though, because it was out of shit on.
No, McCaffrey had 150 yards rushing and 130 receiving.
Yeah, we gonna catch his highlights.
He a dog. McCaffrey a dog. I'm waiting to see him this year, though. McCaffrey a dog, bro.
Wonder what McCaffrey nickname, man. Gotta get that boy a nickname.
And Carson Wentz versus Russell Wilson first week.
I like that game. Cool. Coach Seattle.
Coach, now that's a game I cut on. For sure, for sure.
I'm a big Russell Wilson fan. I'm fucking with homie.
Wanna see what Jameis gonna do too, bro? Green Bay, New Orleans.
Man, I think we all right, bro. Sean Payton, bro. That's the common denominator. Dude don't really be losing. Period. And he has a lot of games with main people out, which a lot of coaches may have a lot of games with it too, but I think his record is going to be top of the top without his main people, without Drew Brees and Michael Thomas and Alvin Kamara, whoever out. I just saw it. I forgot exactly what it was, but... That's like he won all of them. Like, he ain't even really lose without nobody. Whenever somebody out, we win. Like...
He the best coach in the league, bro. Like, for real, for real. They don't say it, but he the best coach in the league. Sean Payton the best coach in the league.
He can actually say that.
He the best coach in the league right now.
Sean P. We gotta give dude his flowers, man.
He really proven. He one of them coaches that I can say in the league, because I don't want to say he's the only one that done it, but I really have to go back and check my research on his track record. But they ain't been able to figure him out really for like 10 years straight. 10, 12 years straight, they still ain't figured him out yet. He been a top 5 offense in the league since he's been coaching the Saints. We ain't never go down to 12, 11 offense. We ain't never go down.
Nah, we ain't got no stat check or nothing like that, but I'm with you.
I said that first. We don't have a stat checker. I might not be fully right. But he top 2 in that. He top 3. Yeah, he top something in that. For sure, for sure. He one of the only head coaches I think can see every year of my NFL career I was a top 5 offense. They probably were the only year they probably wasn't a top 5 offense was 06. From 07 on out, when Reggie Bush flipped in the end zone and all that, when we went to the NFC Championship.
The first year. His first year.
Yeah, no, but we ain't go to the NFC Championship his first year.
Yeah, I'm just saying, it don't matter your first year. I'm talking about
the second year. I'm going to just say from the second year on out.
It really was early on.
Yeah, from the second year on out, he's been top 5 offense in the league every year.
Yeah, as soon as Reggie Bush got there.
Soon as Reggie got that out, you know. So I get that to him. I get that to the Saints, Sean Payton, man.
It's good drafting, too. Free agent, good drafting.
And he pick his players, bro. You know, he pick his players.
I don't see it being too much different this year, bro. We're going to be able to score the ball. We got talent, bro. We got a coach like Sean Payton. We gonna be scoring the ball, period. James Winston, I don't see him to be. Now that's a bold prediction, I put. James Winston gonna be in the MVP discussion. That's my bold prediction. Winston will be in an MVP discussion end of the year. Cause Saints gonna probably most likely be from 11-5 to 13-3. And he gonna be a main reason. Mm-mm. And Sean Payton gonna be probably the biggest reason. But
slinging his pill.
He's gonna be slinging his pill, man. Elvin Kamara gonna be doing his thing. I think that's my bold prediction right there. James Winston, MVP candidate. Sean Payton, coach of the year. You ain't gonna have no choice but to respect him. Bill Belichick lost time. No playoffs. Drew Brees gone.
Super Bowl.
We're gonna see what's going on. We're gonna see what's going on. You feel me? We gonna show you for real. You know. But cool on that schedule. Just to touch on a little bit more football before we get to this basketball. With the draft, man, we had 5 quarterbacks in the first round, bro. You said it's the best quarterback draft ever. Yeah. You said that last year.
Yeah.
Best quarterback draft ever. I don't know, bro.
It might be.
I don't know, bro.
I love Trevor. This looked like the one that finally all of them going to succeed. That's what it looked like to me. I never had a draft that even looked like this before. Now, they have to go out there and go do it. That's why I'm saying it that way. But it looked like all of these guys about to be successful. Something about this class, it looked like all of them going to come in the league and hold their weight. Play 10 years.
Start. I feel you. I like just think reality going to hit in, and it's the NFL. And I think it's just hard for a lot of quarterbacks to be successful.
It's hard.
I just think it's hard for all of them really can't be successful in winning ways. You can have good seasons losing. You can have good winning season and managing a game. There's different ways you can be successful, but I just don't see it. Like that, just to me, that don't happen. Like 5 quarterbacks and all of them.
Who's going to win?
Doing their thing.
Who going to win the most? What rookie going to win the most games this year?
Don't really go nowhere. Look at Tom Brady, man. That's one spot he been having for 20-some years.
Right.
You know, that's one spot gone. He got 30 left. We talking about 5 of them straight here. Boom, boom. I don't know.
I see. One of them gonna do real good. For sure.
I wanted to bring up this. Yeah. With the draft. So I see you with Joe Horn. I saw him. He was complaining. Well, I ain't see him. I read it something. And he was like, my son was the first defensive player drafted.
Right.
That's big. My son was the first defensive player drafted to, who he went to, I think. Did he go to Carolina? I think he went to Carolina.
No,
I think he went to Carolina, cornerback. First defensive player in. Something happened either the next. Oh, that's what was going on. He said it was just talking about Aaron Rodgers. I guess something happened with Aaron Rodgers with the Packers. He probably, that's when it first came out. He was thinking about leaving or something like
right.
that. He went to Carolina Panthers. Boom.
You know, he played for South Carolina.
Right.
That's why they did that like that.
Boom. And he like, man, these people didn't even mention him, my son. He just got drafted, the first defensive player on the board, and they talking about Aaron Rodgers the whole time. You know, I'm like, damn, that's kind of messed up. Like, you know, you the first 8 pick, number one defensive player coming off the board. Nobody knew about it.
Right.
Y'all talking about Aaron Rodgers. It's like he just like, and he just took all the... all the excitement out.
That's cool,
this big
bro.
Old moment, you know. It's big for you know.
Shout out to Horn, man.
J.C. Horn, man. First
nice.
Cornerback, first defensive player off the board in the draft.
Nice, locked up.
And
I want to say
half
SEC.
The world don't even know it because
I think he was SEC
who was watching
defensive
it.
Player of the year.
Right.
I want to say he was SEC defensive.
And they talking about Aaron Rodgers, man, because he said something. Think about that, commentators and all that. He just took a whole lot of shine from this young brother who just got drafted, the first defensive player of the draft. And we talking about Aaron Rodgers, man. Come on now. Shout out J.C. Horn, man.
J.C. Horn, man. Shout out.
You handle your business, man.
Locked down. I just told you Carolina's going to be good. Now you got him on one side and Dante Jackson. I was
garbage bowl first game, though.
Yeah, I know. Because they're going to beat the piss out the Jets. I feel sorry for my dog, Zach Wilson. I feel sorry for my little dog, Week 1.
I don't know. Quarterbacks like that change shit.
Oh, yeah. He run around and shit.
Nah, so that's what I... Lamar Jackson, you probably thought that his first year too, first game. Yeah, garbage bowl. They're going to beat the shit out of Baltimore. Now, I can't remember his first game with that, but from the gate, he was doing his thing.
Well, you know, you respecting Baltimore just all the end. You could go underneath center, bitch.
You right.
Yeah, nigga, respecting Baltimore.
You right, for sure, yeah.
Yeah, Baltimore could come out. You still like, man, I don't know.
Yeah,
what they giving
really
them?
I could go under center, though. Yeah, let's run this
they
thing.
Giving up? Shit.
Let's run this thing, whatever the coach name
that's
is.
That's a garbage bowl, though.
I fuck with Harbaugh.
Him and his brother. His brother don't got no job no more, man.
Michigan fired him?
No, he had Michigan, man. NFL job. But, man, he need to get it together. Speaking on him, he need to get it together, him over there at Michigan. They getting their ass whipped every year by Ohio State. He really
that's
was
the only game. It's the only game he's supposed to
he
win.
Went, yeah, it's the only game he's supposed to win. Ohio State, you can't even.
I like. I kind of wanted Jim Harbaugh, but to be in the lead, but that Kaepernick shit fucked him up too. I think, to be real,
right?
Because if that dude was still playing, he'll still be winning. Things wouldn't end, you know. And I want to say he still was winning. I forgot what happened, why he got up out there. It's, you know, I think it was just
disgruntled. He had that losing season, and he was he copped out at the right time. You know, college coaches get paid more than the NFL coaches, except for John Gruden. John Gruden, boy, he on the hot seat. They gave him $100 million, first $100 million coach. He on the hot seat, him. He on the high seat. Yeah, John Gruden.
So that
playoffs. It's must playoffs for John Gruden off the dump. He in his third year.
So how that coaching money go? He ain't guaranteed. He get fired as old with.
They might have some type of buyout agreement. Some, you know. I think it's different than the coach. I think the coaches have more guaranteed money against the players. Know why? Because they ain't going to go out there and get hurt. The players' money ain't guaranteed in the NFL because it's most high injuries. That's why they don't give you the guaranteed money that the other sports get. Because you could get hurt right now.
Yeah, that's what I heard about. I think they contract with the guaranteed money, too. Because say you contract $10 million and $5 of it guaranteed. If you're not on the roster a year after that contract, say you get this contract this year, but we release you within 12 months. Like, that money ain't even guaranteed. Nah, that even go for if you had $48 million guaranteed, you just got $86 million, $48 guaranteed. we release you within this next 12 months or that 1 year. Like, it really don't start till after the 1 year.
Right.
And I thought about it. I said, well,
why I say, man, the players right now in the NFL, for real, y'all need to get together and put y'all foot down. Y'all are the league. The NFL been pimping y'all for years. You know what I'm saying? Like I was reading earlier, Ty Gurley, when they released him from the Rams, they released him on the day that in 24 hours, they would have had to pay him $10.2 million. They released him so they wouldn't have to pay him that. Well, what sense that contract really made? They never was going to pay him that before the contract. Like, that's bullshit. That's not going on in the NBA. It's not going on. They getting their bread. That ain't going on in baseball.
So, yeah, that's why.
They getting their bread, dog. Players... Ain't no, I'm going to cut you today so I won't have to pay you tomorrow. Huh?
Yeah.
What the fuck?
Now, look.
You know?
This is why it's hard, though. I understand why it's hard. But
the injuries, that's why.
No, it's the players who not getting paid. Everybody ain't getting Tom Brady money up in here. Everybody ain't getting that DN money, that cornerback money, you know.
Right.
So you talking about what? 10, 15 people who really getting paid on the team?
Right.
And it's, you know, it's probably showing. But they got 50 players in here. And 20 of them probably getting under a million. You know, they only going home with 200 some thousand at the end of the year. They ain't make no money compared, you know. Y'all getting 200,000 every week with y'all check.
Right. Yeah, that's what I'm saying.
So you want them dudes to go,
like, I ain't mistaken, like
boycott, and they ain't even getting no money, you know.
Yeah, Cam Newton, he played for $1 million this year, that just passed. But no, he played for like one per something, but they really all of it wasn't got. It was like really like a $800,000 contract or something, man. Like, them dudes getting pimped, man, in the NFL. And they getting pimped in the NFL, bro.
Yeah.
I'm going to cut you today so I don't have to pay you tomorrow.
You know, luckily Cam has some good contracts already where he, you know, it's probably not about the money for him no more.
Yeah, it ain't about the money for him. You build a team around him, you know.
I mean, just to play for that, to see. He's probably, and you know, he could easily be like, I'm worth more than that. But to keep playing and, you know, show you know you really love the game. But
we won't get on this NBA, man.
NBA, bro. Yeah, bro. NBA, man. The NBA, bro. I mean, I started off with this Russell Westbrook, bro. Russell Westbrook done passed Oscar Robertson. He got the most triple doubles in NBA history, bro. A point guard, you know.
He a dog. Say what you want about him.
Oh, he a dog. He could get in the underdog for sure. He a dog. He play real hard.
I was just telling the nigga earlier. Say what you want about Westbrook, right? Name any one of them niggas. He better than them though. I don't care what you say about team. Woo 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 woo. Name any one of them. He uncheckable. Can't nobody in that league still can't check him right now. Still up and down. Still up and down the court. He gonna go back to a contender. Don't get it true. Everybody still saying he gonna be like Karl Malone and all this shit at the, you know, uptown. And they like he gonna be this woody woody woo Charles Barkley, Patrick Ewing.
Somebody put him in there with Karl Malone.
Yeah, they say
because he ain't gonna have a ring.
Yeah, everybody writing him off saying that he'll never get a ring. I feel like he still got a good 5 more years of playing real good. And I think he going to...
I think
he going to get one, dog. I think he going to get one. Somebody going to pick him up and know who I see him playing with, who tone his game down, and make him a better player than what he is, LeBron. I could see him playing with the Lakers in the next. I could see him playing with the Lakers.
No, indeed, no.
I could see him playing with the Lakers.
I can't.
I could see him playing with the Lakers, though. They're going to get out and run and go.
I can't see him playing with the Lakers. Nah.
Two more years from now, when LeBron to that point where he ain't got to run, He ain't got to run the
Westbrook
show.
Westbrook go play for the Lakers. Westbrook gave up. He gave up.
Right, meaning he still don't.
Because that's not even a fit, man. That's not even a fit.
Not a fit.
No, man, dude, who suspect shooting the ball with LeBron, who is not the best shooter, you know. He gonna make some shots, but nah, not Russell Westbrook.
LeBron is gonna be slowing down to where he gonna start having to play with other people that can handle the ball now. Where he ain't gotta just wear himself down and just like always have the ball. Where he ain't really gotta be the point forward no more.
Yeah, but he
just kept
the ball in his hands. It's the best option. So, give a fuck if he's slowing down. And I guess he may have slowing down a little bit. We don't see the hand way back here when he dunking no more and all that. But, man.
He really ain't slowing down.
He has the brain that you need. He has the brain. Yeah, he got the body and the strength and the... But he has the brain and the capability of doing whatever to make us win. You know, it's a league.
What's a fit for Russ outside of Washington? They said Boston was liking him, but, you know, they got Tatum and Brown, so, you know.
No, I think Russ is going there and I ain't gonna say that. I was gonna say that Russ going there and mess that up because
they got a coach though. See, that's the difference.
They do have a coach, but man, how you not gonna let Russ? I mean, if you're thinking on Russ changing, yeah, well, how we gonna know who gonna change?
Right.
And like you know, I'm talking about Russ Westbrook. What he doing? We don't need him. Nah, man, you got Tatum. You got a superstar right there. You got Jaylen Brown. You got a slick side superstar right there. Russell, if you're not trying to come average 20 assists,
would you fit with the Clippers? With Doc, you know,
Ty Lue, right?
You got to share the ball with Kyrie and Paul George.
I think I would like him with the Clippers. They'll be hell of a defensive team. You think you got Patrick Beverly? We replace him with Russell Westbrook?
Right.
Now, see, I could see that working because they all older. And I think Russell respect
them too.
Them too, as far as, man, y'all do it. Yeah, I go to 15
and
assists
y'all want
now.
Me to kill him.
I don't have to average 25, 24, 20. I'm gonna go to 15 points, 15 assists, dude. He could do something like that. He can go still average a triple double and let y'all go to work. I'll get my easy 6-5 layups off of.
I gotta see how their money is though. According to the Clippers money, who their money really tied up into. I know they got money tied up into them too. But who else they got money tied up into?
Yeah, I mean, if Russ go there, though, I think...
I don't think they got a third player that they really tied up to with money. Like, I don't think they have a third max player. Like, you know, they got Serge Ibaka and them and shit, but I can't think offhand a third max player on the Clippers right now.
You may have to get rid of Morris Twin or something, you know. You may have to... That'd be tough. But I like him with Washington, man. I like him and Bradley Beal. Your backcourt gonna get that work tonight.
Can they get a free agent to come in now?
See, that's the thing. They would need one more.
Can they get a free agent? Can they get a free agent any and night, some role players to come in
any there? Night? You don't know what's going to happen. You playing against Russell Westbrook and Bradley Beal. I don't care. It could be me, you, and De Niro, the other three. Yeah. Them dudes had like 80-something, man, together the other night, man. I'm looking at this shit. I'm like, what the fuck? Westbrook had 30-something. Bradley Beal had 40-something.
Serious, Bradley. I told you, Bradley Beal, serious, dog. You know, only other guard in the league that's better than him is, you know, James Harden, bro. If it ain't Harden, you ain't better than him. Guards. All guards in the league. Two guard, one, I don't care, whatever. To me, right now in the league. You know what I mean? they're the best two guards in the they're the best two guards in the league. Well, you know, I ain't gonna leave one person out though, Devin Booker. I ain't gonna leave Book out. Booker, but you behind them.
No,
right now.
Yeah,
but
you young, say,
you behind
we
them.
Respect
too.
Booker.
You behind them.
But Booker,
right
you
now.
Ain't doing what Bradley Beal
doing right now. Yeah,
no.
he ain't doing what he's
doing.
You
ain't doing. Let's keep it all the way G.
You ain't doing what he's doing.
Bradley Beal, yeah, you cold. Yeah. You gonna woo woo.
I'm gonna be a third every night.
Yeah,
Bradley
you done had what he had 71 or something?
Yeah, he had 71 on
tomorrow,
71.
Salute to 71 for sure. But man, Bradley Beal and them, man, they giving you 40 and shit every night. 35 for sure, like. I think him and Steph Curry
got him by like a point something.
What they at? 34, 35 points or some shit, man. Something crazy.
Steph at 34 points something, and he at 33 points something. And they both got two more games left. So both
and
I'm
he
trying
hurt,
to
though.
Drop, both I'm trying
hurt.
To drop 60. It Bill hurt.
That's I like that.
Bill
coming.
That's why I say, but I'm going to keep a G, though, dog. If I'm Washington, bro, what I got my hands on, instead of me really trying to risk, I don't know, dog, because it could go both ways. They could try to pick somebody else to come in there with them, but they still have to build a team. But I feel like if they just want to get some asses in the seats, they could get rid of both of them right now and get some shit for both of them. They could get some shit for them.
I wouldn't do it, man.
See what I'm saying?
That's what I would do.
They could get some shit for them, too.
This is what I would do. Well, you got Russell Westbrook and Bradley Beal, man. I would, if your last name ain't Beal or Westbrook, you already know it's popping. You're out of here. We going to get us a third person. I don't care if we got to play with three little dudes out the project. Six more dudes out the high school team. Because, man, think about it, bro. KD, Kyrie, Harden.
Joe Harris and them, they were stars, though.
Me and you know who Joe Harris is. The other NBA teams know who these other dudes on the teams is. You may know Blake Griffin just got traded over there.
Right.
Like.
But they ain't really got no team, no bitch.
They don't need nobody else, man. That's the thing. They don't need nobody else, man. That's all about hooking up the right disposable players you could get, whatever. I ain't gonna say they just everywhere out there, but man, you gotta be on your game as a GM and fit the right players around to make sure you helping the weaknesses of those three players.
But
them three
like
players gonna get you there.
All the players that could really go out there and help them is locked up. So like
I don't think that's true, bro. Yeah, locked up, you get traded. We about to give you draft picks, we about to give you anybody else but Westbrook or Bill. And we going to get, you know, whoever we got to get. That's like the Pelicans. I feel like we could feel like we don't have a Bradley Beal, Russell Westbrook in dominance yet. But we got a Zion and a B.I. who's up and coming could be that. We should be getting rid of everybody to go get Bradley Beal. You see what I'm saying?
Yeah.
That's how I feel.
Boy, Pelicans. Yeah.
Yeah, and we go get Lestu out the Magnolia. We go get O'Ball. We go get fuck. We go get Bo Lester. We go get his little brother. We go get Lamar. They can run with them dudes and we going somewhere. Real talk though, like that can really happen. Nah, I don't know if that may happen. It's political, but man, come on, man. Bradley Beal, Zion, and Brandon Ingram. Just think about it. Bradley Beal, James Harden. It's, you know, we're going to even out.
Same thing.
Even out. Yeah. Harden, you know, he's going to dish it a little bit more. He could, you know, keep the ball in his hand a little bit more, but cool. I mean, not dishing the move, Bradley Beal. I'm going to just give you 50 tonight.
Right.
You feel me? Like, he can do that at any time. B.I. can do that.
I fuck with that dude.
B.I. can give you 30. He should be able to give you 30 at any night, especially with a Bradley Beal on the floor.
That's right.
You're going one-on-one me? I'm 7 feet tall. It's really nobody you could put in front of me, man, to just stop me, bro. You need help.
Right.
Zion. The whole arena know he's shooting right about the goal. He going to shoot right there, fellas. Hey, he going to shoot right there. And he averaging 30, and we all know he's shooting right there.
He going to break Karl Malone's
record. Think about that, man.
He going to break Karl Malone's record,
bro. Think about that, bro. We really one player away. We got the most unique player ever. I mean, it's early on. A Charles Barkley.
I want Bradley Beal. Throw the house at them people, man, for Bradley.
Bradley Beal, man, we get Bradley Beal. I even say a Devin Booker. We get a Devin Booker with a Zion
But I'm going to tell you what we're another combination we'll be real good with. Just say we was to add Russell Westbrook and DeMar DeRozan. See, DeMar DeRozan about to be a free agent. He about to get out there with the Spurs. I already know he about to run from the Spurs. Popovich, it might be, I don't know.
I fuck with DeMar. I think he'll help any team.
Yeah, he's a solid two.
I preferably would want a two who can shoot the three, though.
Oh, Mo gang.
You know, I just rather a three-point shooter in this day and age with all the scoring. And if you really can shoot it with Zion.
The crazy thing about it is how far DeMar DeRozan the stock them when it looked down. We probably could get him with Bill. We probably could get Bill and then stumble across him.
Yeah, DeRozan.
And have both of them.
DeRozan on his bottom end, but he's still a...
He can still be your starting two guard. Yeah,
for sure. He can still be your starting two. We don't need him to be the best player on the team. But I would love to have him, but we need Bradley Beal. We need Devin Booker.
Hey, they was asking,
We got a question?
Yeah. Somebody had asked if Dennis Rodman could check Kevin Durant. No, that's the answer. Can Dennis Rodman check Kevin Durant? No. Period. You want to speak on it? I don't even have nothing
else.
I can't. We
bro.
Can't. We.
Damn, bro.
It's nothing else to
don't
talk about.
I don't think you can say it like that, because that's Rodman, man.
I don't care what it
man,
is.
Man, that's Rodman. What you mean? It's the dude who going KD tweeting niggas bagging all that, man. What you think? Rodman ain't going to get under your skin?
But listen, bro. Listen, though. I'm going to tell you the reason
that's
why.
That's a good question, man. Rodman probably going to. Fucking
so you,
right.
So you think Dennis Rodman was going out there trying to check Clyde Drexler?
And Rodman was checking whoever.
No, he wasn't. That boy wasn't going on no perimeter, man. Man, fuck no. Man, that boy can't check no Kevin Durant. That's Rodman. That's my error. I love you and all that, boy. Kevin Durant would have fucked you up. Kevin Durant would have fucked that boy up, man. Come on, see. No, indeed, no, man. He'd have locked everybody else up but him. For real, though. Rodman was a dog.
Man, nah, I'm saying all that. But bad KD could put 30 on whoever.
Yeah.
Like,
that's what I'm saying. That's why the answer is no. Yeah. You see?
So if that's why the answer is no. If we had Rodman, you got KD tonight, nigga.
You
got KD, nigga. Talk your shit. Do what you got to do.
Yeah.
Do your Rodman thing. Get some charges, you know. But man, that's KD, bro. We talking about.
Now I'm going to keep a G. I think Scotty could. See? I'm going to go with Scotty. You know, I know the question was if you know, Can Rodman do it? No. Scottie? Yeah.
You know who I would
if they could play with the old school rules too. If they could play with the rules you with know the hand checking and shit. Yeah, if they could play with the old rules with the hand checking and shit like that, yeah, I'm going with Pippen.
You know who I go with?
Oh.
MJ.
Mike. No
way. Going with Mike, man.
He gonna do him this here. This here.
Man, look here.
This here, all D.
No, ain't no all D. Nothing here. With MJ.
This here, I'm gonna put you on my back.
MJ up here too with it.
This here.
Yeah, he's 6'6". Yeah, all right. You think you gonna, you know, he gonna do something. Just how you come get that thing from Karl Malone. Let me get that out you.
Mm-hmm.
You know, it's some off-ball help, but I'm Jordan on you. One play, I'm putting Jordan on you.
I'm putting Scottie.
I feel you. That's an argument. They say they used to fight over who gon'.
Yeah.
No, nigga. Yeah, I got him.
Got another question from the well.
What you got? What we got? Hell yeah.
Yeah.
He might be better.
Because he cut like that.
What? Kevin Durant he can go down as the best scorer ever.
He cut like that.
Ever, though. That's like all of them.
But.
That's Karl Malone, then. That's
He could have played in the old era, but he wouldn't have put the numbers would have been a little bit lower than what they is right now. Just what? Because, no, not off of what he capable of doing just because of the way the game was played.
You think
he wouldn't have been he wouldn't have been shooting it at that high volume of shots. You know, how they shoot it right now. He wouldn't know.
He don't need the shots. It's not like he shooting a bad percentage or something.
He wouldn't have been shooting as many threes.
If KD would have played 40 years ago.
He wouldn't have been shooting as many threes.
We wouldn't be talking about Michael Jordan, man.
No, man.
Man, we wouldn't. Think about it. If this boy was back then.
Right.
He's 7 feet. He a unicorn.
He's 7 feet tall.
It's 2020 and he a unicorn. 40 years ago, they would have thought he was an alien, you know.
They would have thought that nigga was an alien.
What? You talking about, they going to be looking at him like, this dude Kareem size, I mean height, even though Kareem probably was a little bit taller than him. But he shoot the ball from way back there.
Right.
With ease.
Kevin Durant probably is the most talented basketball player we ever seen. But that'd be hard to say because of LeBron James. But
it's not the talent thing. They have guards who is just as talented as Kevin Durant. You know.
Right.
But Kevin Durant 7 feet tall and can do the same thing you could do as, and you 6'5". I can handle the rock just as good as you. And I can shoot it better than you, and I'm 7 feet tall. That's the big distinguish. I can shoot it better than you. I can get an easier shot. Come on, man. I don't care what era Kevin Durant was in. Like, it didn't matter. He was skinny. They had some skinny dudes in the league back then. You know, when you look back at it.
Kevin Durant is dog, son. I ain't gonna lie, boy. But you know.
Yeah, think about it, but he scores the most. I mean, I think he's on pace to have the most points ever.
But see, they had better defensive players in the league back then, dog.
Well, what else you want him to do? He's scoring the most points now.
Yeah, because, you know.
Because of what?
They ain't playing defense right now. Dude.
He's 7 feet tall. Who's supposed to do it? He a unicorn.
True. But they not playing defense right now.
He a unicorn, bro.
Like you said, it don't matter. Michael Jordan was 6'6". Like, I'm going to keep it real. Boy, Charles Barkley would have checked the fuck out Kevin Durant. Charles Barkley.
Charles Barkley.
I'm talking about the MVP 1993 Slim Charles Barkley. MVP of the league, averaging 30. Charles Barkley. He would have checked the fuck out Durant.
So tell me this.
That Barkley, not the Houston
Charles
Barkley.
Charles Barkley has better defense than PJ Tucker?
Fucking right.
That's a fucking right?
Yeah, ain't no comparison. PJ Tucker? No, indeed.
Defensively, not
player. Defensively, nah. Barkley was a beast. 6'6", check all positions, too. Barkley go run out there on John Stockton them and shit, boy. But
I feel like PJ Tucker is an elite defender. I think I could give him that respect.
Yeah, Barkley was an above elite defender. Great defender. He was some. If you could put Rodman on him, you could put Barkley on him.
No, man. Oh, Barkley wasn't. Barkley couldn't have been better than Rodman on D Dog.
Dog. Barkley done won Defensive Player of the Year in the NBA and shit.
Did he?
Yeah.
Check that. Did he? Let me see that, Charles. Defensive Player of the Year?
Let me see.
I know he won MVP. But I forgot what subject we was on running about right just now.
Kevin Durant.
Kevin Durant, man. Yeah, man, can play any era, man. Dude, man, come on, man. That dude talking about he better than LeBron. Just think about it. And it's an argument. And LeBron is the man. He a unicorn. That's how I feel. LeBron. It's like nothing of LeBron and KD is the dude who... telling them chill out. Like, you know, and people gonna respect that. Some people gonna go with LeBron. I think more people gonna go with LeBron, but some people gonna go with KD. But you gotta respect KD, man. You know, you may not respect his decisions, but it don't matter what team he go to. He gonna be the best player on it. You feel me? Nah, yeah, you went to a player with, but... I'm the best player on this bitch. It don't matter what team I go to, I'm the best player on it. He go by LeBron right now, you know it's gonna be KD.
It's gonna be KD team.
It may not be, damn, that's hard to say who team is gonna be, but KD gonna average 35. LeBron gonna average 20.
Speaking on the Lakers, what's going on with the Lakers and man, the Lakers moving forward.
Man, the Lakers, look here. They getting healthy.
You got to go play around and run behind Steph, look like.
Yeah, it's a tricky year. It's a tricky year. But how I look at it, it's going to come down to LeBron going to come back. He going to get his groove back. Somebody may luck up in this first little round and beat him a game or two. They going to get their groove back. Right. And it's gonna be the LeBron.
Yeah, because I like their team. I think they're deep. I think they built their bench. Everything.
Gonna be nice. We got Drummond right there. Drummond gonna be coming along playing with them.
Cause this allowed their team to play heavy minutes. They've been losing a lot of games, but they've been losing games because they're not gonna have to ask them guys to do what they've been having to do lately. You know what I'm saying? So when the team get back healthy, Anthony Davis and LeBron come back, those other guys got big minutes this year, gonna be ready to come play the little minutes now. They're gonna play the little minutes real good because they done all played like 20 games of real minutes.
I like that.
This season, so I feel like that's going to help them out in the long run. The injury going to help them out in the long run.
I still feel like Lakers still the team to beat in the West.
No, I ain't going to say that. That's how I feel like. The team to beat in the West right now is the Clippers. The Clippers and the Jazz. They could beat the Lakers, dog. For real, dog. Utah got a good team. They remind me of, they're the new Spurs. We thought Toronto was coming with some Spurs shit in Boston, but... Utah is the real deal, old school, look like Jerry Sloan Jazz right now. They look like the John Stockton them Jazz right now with fucking, what's his name? Kindly at the point guard with my boy Donovan Mitchell. He was the MVP candidate till he got hurt. You know what I'm saying?
I like
what's your boy name like that they Utah didn't have last year in the playoffs? Number 44, Bogdanovic or whatever. The boy had 49 the other night. Almost dropped a 50 ball.
Jordan Clarkson over there, too, huh?
Clarkson over there. He going to get most NBA improved player of the year. He going to get most improved
player. I like
player. Utah. Utah can go to the finals. Nigga laughed at me when they when I told him that today.
You shouldn't laugh.
They shouldn't laugh.
Because this is a main thing for me with Utah.
They could just play basketball and
Mike Conley.
Yeah, the point.
Mike Conley. Even though, because they got a squad. The left-handed.
Yeah, Ingles.
Foreign Ingles.
They got Ingles, but he not the Bogdanović.
Yeah, I'm just giving you pieces. He's naked, you know. Yeah. He you know they
Clarkson,
got
Clarkson killer.
Clarkson,
Royce O'Neal, spot up shooter, gonna knock it down.
Yeah, Gobert down there holding it down.
Defensive player of the year and all that before, I think.
Couple times,
man. The dude nice down low. He gonna protect the paint. He gonna run the flow and he make his free throws.
See, make it hard for you down there. It's different.
He different playing Utah, boy.
Mike Conley, though. Point guard who don't really make mistakes, can shoot the three. He the baby Chris Paul.
Right.
Mike Conley.
Right.
Don't do nothing wrong. Every night is going to be hard to beat him.
Every night going
to be. Because he gonna come to play. Fast, smart, can make every level. You know?
Yeah, I told him it could be something crazy. You know, it really can be the Clippers versus the Jazz to go to the finals. Who would have ever thought two small cities, what if it be the Jazz and the Bucks in the title?
Possible, but it's not going to happen.
I got the Bucks going. I think the Bucks just got better and better every year, dog. They have that championship experience, meaning they got that experience, dog. They team ready. They ready to go to the finals. I think the Bucks really ready. The Bucks can beat this Brooklyn year, in the series, dog. This year tricky, dog.
I feel you.
The Bucks could beat them in the
gonna
series.
We're going to have us a nice finals this year. We're going to have us a nice one. You know.
Whoever go.
It ain't whoever. It's going to be the Lakers in Brooklyn.
No.
It's going to be the Lakers in Brooklyn, man.
It's not going to be.
We're going to get the KD LeBron back at it. You know, KD back with a super team. You feel me? LeBron got a super dog.
The Bucks going.
I got the Lakers in Brooklyn, man. Clippers not going to be able to beat the Lakers. I don't think they got enough. That Paul George shit, all that shit ain't gonna be done. Kawhi, you ain't ready for this smoke right here. You know, you lucked up LeBron went in the malls when you won it with Toronto, even though you did your thing. And I get Kawhi's respect. LeBron gonna respect him too, but y'all don't have enough. Utah
got a team that can beat the Lakers.
LeBron gonna beat you.
They got
sweep you. They probably gonna sweep you.
Fuck no.
You feel me? That's what LeBron do teams like that. Who think they got it. You feel me? You know what I'm saying? They ain't did this shit before. Uh-uh. Watch. I'm sweeping people, man. And they like that. I see a team like Phoenix. I give them a better chance than Utah.
They could go
me.
To the finals. Phoenix could go to the finals for real.
You got Chris Paul, man. Hey, bro.
It's a tricky year.
You better
bro.
Respect the dude, man.
It's
Chris
a tricky
Paul.
Year.
Every game, I treat him like LeBron. He not LeBron, but I treat him like LeBron. Because every night it's gonna be hard to beat that dude. The every ball night. In his hand most
yes,
of the time.
And with Devin Booker, they about to make it hard.
The ball in Chris Paul hand most of the time.
I said, brother, dude from Villanova and all them dudes, Jay Crowder and all them dudes, come play their roles, huh? Your boy, what's your boy name? Who start? Mikal Bridges. Mikal Bridges, dude, nice,
man,
yeah.
What? That dude look like Vince Carter, man.
Do you know he won the championship 2 years with Villanova as a freshman and as a...
I didn't know that boy was that good.
Villanova, man, that dude was good.
And
Villanova.
I didn't know he could jump like that.
Yeah, man.
He...
And he shoot the three and everything good.
Man, he come and poke on you.
Yeah, Mikal Bridges.
He come and poke on you, boy. I like the little squad, Phoenix. But Chris Paul, man, he stay held in his playoffs. It's going to be hard.
And the team that just looked real good, and the two Murray guys are down there. Denver really was championship ready. Denver championship ready, boy. They deep.
I don't believe in them. Straight up. I don't believe in them.
Jokic and them, they have to do it on the stage.
I like Jokic. Jokic's like that. Jokic, he for real deal.
Poor Michael Porter Jr.
He's similar. He, you know, he LeBron Nimish because the ball in his hand.
What about Porter?
For Denver?
Yeah.
I like him. Young boy. I like him.
He's stepping up big this year, too.
I like him. I think they tough. I don't think they ready chemistry-wise and who gonna do what.
I'm saying with Murray, dangerous.
I wasn't believing in him with Murray. I wasn't believing in him. You got me. What you gonna do? You got LeBron a first round on the second round. You gonna beat him when? None of them. You not gonna beat him. That's how I don't believe in him. I'm thinking about who you gotta play. I ain't thinking about, oh, y'all good, man. Y'all got a good team. Man, is you gonna beat them big dogs to get to this chip? That's what it come down to. Or you gonna beat them big dogs to go to that chip? That's what we talking about. Lakers.
It's just crazy stuff been happening.
You gotta prove it. You gotta come beat them dudes, man.
And Utah is a good team. Utah is something like the Spurs, boy. You don't wanna play them in the series. They gonna open up a clinic on you.
So don't say nothing. By the car, you
Lakers, man. Lakers, man. LeBron,
we don't know.
Man.
See, that's the thing, bro.
How we don't know?
Put, you know.
Tell me how we don't know.
Lakers was hurt.
Where LeBron been at the last 2 years, bro? Tell me where he be at.
Yeah.
Tell me where he go.
But yeah, one year he didn't make the playoff.
He was hurt.
Yeah, he
that's
hurt.
The only year he
and he missed Buku games.
No,
bro.
But they in the playoffs.
Yeah.
And he playing. Where he be at? You tell me.
Yeah.
You talking about we don't know. Fuck, we don't know. Man, where LeBron at every year, man? And he round that chip, man. Get cut show. He round that chip, man. Yes, indeed, man. You know where LeBron going, man. It don't matter what side he on. The West, the East, nothing. Man, it don't matter, man. You got to play LeBron. He just toured. You know, I don't care if I'm 6'7", 8". It don't matter. I walk in your gym, game one, you got a problem. Straight up.
Straight up.
You got a problem. Ask Toronto. They can't beat him. They thought they had the best team they ever had. Man, get up out of here, man. Boston. Tatum them. Young Tatum them. They still had a young squad, man. Get up out of here, man. time after time, you sure you don't. Time after time. And last year, I respect that bubble shit.
Man, well, it was hard to win. Man, look,
everybody doing the same shit.
Right.
How even you
really could bubble.
How more even you want it? It's some AAU shit, but y'all got real schemes and coaches and systems.
This a real
this league. This elite pickup NBA shit, man. Who gonna win here? This real. I feel like this real. It's real. That's why I wanted Phoenix in there. Phoenix showed you, bitch. Devin Booker showed you.
Mm-hmm.
He put his mark on us on the yeah right quick. They went 8-0 or something.
And Devin Booker
and
yeah,
couldn't even get in the offs. I think like
right
about one game or something or close to it.
That's why I said you could draw them and think you're sweet. The Clippers and all
that's
that.
That's the one.
Clippers could jog Phoenix and think you're sweet and get knocked out.
Man, yeah, man. I'm respecting Phoenix. That's my top team to respect.
I'm respecting you, Tuttle. Because Donovan Mitchell coming. He showed me he going to be whoever. He going to be who he is no matter who he play. When he done showed me against the big people and everything. Donovan Mitchell going to be that guy against whoever. I give it to him. He played the Lakers. You know, he's averaging 29 in the series. And, you know, he going to, yeah.
That's all I'm saying with it. I feel like Phoenix, out of everybody in that West, could beat everybody but the Lakers. I feel like Utah.
They're number one in the West, and dog.
Utah the last can get beat by more teams than Phoenix, I feel like.
In the last 10, 15 years, dog, really, in the last 20 years, be honest. When a team that wasn't good, like, wasn't top-notch, that won the West, like, you know, winning the East and shit always been cool, but, dog, when you finish first in the West, that's saying something, dog. It's saying something, dog.
All thing it said to me was LeBron wasn't over there.
LeBron and still wouldn't have finished number one. Them people was, man, when yeah. LeBron them was.
That's all, that said to me. That means LeBron and
the thick of the season, them people was always 7 games in front of the Lakers, man. 5 games in front of the Lakers all year.
Who?
The Jazz, dog. It ain't no fluke to finish number one in the West.
No,
it ain't no fluke, dog.
They not number one, though.
Yes, they is.
Phoenix ain't getting number one. I thought Phoenix took number one. I mean, I know they up there. I know they 1 or 2. But, yeah, this year in the West, I feel like it's tricky. The whole NBA is tricky. I don't feel like the record.
Yeah, Utah.
All right, yeah, they're a game apart.
2 games apart.
Yeah, 2 games. We got 1 win and 1 less loss.
And they only got like 2 games left. So yeah. It's like, if Utah win their next game, they clinch that number one seed. I'm just saying, that number one seed in that West ain't no hope.
You know what I'm saying, but you ain't had no fans. Ooh.
The seed don't got nothing to do with home and shit. You playing these people. This is who you playing. It's the schedule. That's what whole weight. You number one in the West. It's just the,
no, I'm just
it's
saying,
the schedule itself.
I feel you. I just feel like the season a little flawed with.
Teams being good
as they really can be.
Yeah, they playing 10 less games and shit.
Playing 10 less games. It's a different season, you know. You got it's just all this type of stuff shit, going on. You know, people in and out not playing with COVID. You know, it's just it's a whole lot of stuff going on. Like your best player ain't played this, you know, these last 2 weeks because of COVID. It's all, you know, it's different. So to me, the record didn't just put it all out there with the NBA this year. It's gonna come down to these people.
Oh, we know these big dogs in these playoffs.
Yeah, man, like that's what it's gonna come down
to. But it's gonna be fans in the playoffs. I think it's fans, yeah. Some arenas been full to capacity.
Right, I haven't been on it to really see it like that. But still, fans or without fans. It's going to turn on, you know, like the teams who can play, who they ready. We here now. They got teams still ain't really played together yet, you know. Like Harden ain't even been there. No, but Harden might have. Did he come? He think he came back yesterday.
Yeah, he played. He had 18 plus 15 assists, I think.
Oh, man. Look. I forget he did play. I saw his interview. He said, man, not to brag, but.
No, not to brag.
I'm real good at this game. Talking about how just to come back and feel so normal or whatever. It's basketball, and I'm real good at it. Mm. Period. You know, real good at it.
Yeah, he real good at it.
So them big dogs about to step up, and it's gonna be playoff time, man.
So I understand big dogs about to step up and shit. Niggas be talking, but dog, Milwaukee, they could beat Brooklyn, bro.
I feel you, but it ain't gonna happen. I don't see it, bro. I don't see it. I like the matchup. Drew, Chris Middleton, with Giannis. To me, this is how I feel. I feel like Giannis gonna have to be the second best player on a championship team. I think that's what it's gonna look like. You know, You know, I don't want to see if it's similar to LeBron. It's a little similar to LeBron. But the difference is LeBron did get to the chip. He got that early. As a young boy, he went there. And
this might be the right pieces, though. He got pieces now. They deep. They got a team.
And another thing, LeBron didn't even have a team. And got there. He didn't even have none of this shit. Come on, man.
What you getting them and shit?
Man, he ain't had none of this. Mm-mm. No, indeed, no. So, Brooklyn gone. It's going to click on and Brooklyn going to be Brooklyn to me. I don't think Giannis going to be able to do that to compete with them dudes.
Man, I think they could get their ass knocked off. I think Brooklyn could. They don't play no fucking defense. You know what I mean? What, they going to be there by the 1/3 of the 115? I mean, 1/3 of the 125?
You're fucking right. You're motherfucking right. We got two of the best scorers ever. In the league, right here, on the court, same team and shit. Ever, though. Well, I ain't talking about the niggas who's hot. The two dudes who been shooting it at Rucker.
Right.
Who scored 50 at Rucker twice last week. They even more powerful than that. The two best scorers, arguably ever, to come through the league, man. KD and James Harden. I done heard different people say James Harden may be the best scorer ever. Kevin Durant may be the best scorer ever. Because he's just on pace. He just been scoring since he been in the league. He's been scoring. LeBron too, but KD averaging 30. LeBron 28. KD 31 or something. LeBron 28.
Right.
You know, KD was doing that younger. You know. But,
Harden and KD.
Harden, man, Harden 35 and all that shit. But, you know, Harden came off the bench early, you know.
And they got a little whip around them, though. They got a little whip, too. That's what's scary about them.
Brooklyn.
Yeah, they got, like, Joe Harris and them and shit.
Dudes got straight. A team, man.
Yeah.
And I was bullshitting just saying they could win with anybody. But, man, they got a real squad, man.
And Jeff Green. Come on, man. That man was allowed to pick. They all was together. That's why they got him. They remember that? That they had all four of them together. They was first round picks.
Jeff Green,
James Harden, Westbrook, and him.
I really was playing on them by saying anybody could do it.
Man, Jeff Green.
Because them players they got, them dudes exclusive on some shit, man. They got a perfect
was a lottery pick, man. Jeff Green out Georgetown, man.
Joe Harris, the shooter. They got the big boy, DeAndre Jordan, you know. That's a Rudy Gobert type player. Wit. That's what I'm saying. Think about Utah, you think about Brooklyn. Come on, man. LeBron trying to go beat Brooklyn, man. Got no time for no Utah. Get out of here, man. We're going to sweep y'all, man.
Yeah, man. You know? But I just like Utah, bro. But if LeBron them healthy, yeah, it's over with for Utah.
Yeah, see, LeBron don't be playing with them teams like that. Nah, you gotta really be coming with it. Boston, you know, but Utah got the atmosphere though. The fans come. Utah had an atmosphere to make it something, but man, LeBron come and beat you, man. LeBron come and beat you, dog.
But, to get on
LeBron summer. Be back, dude. LeBron hurt. Rushing that ankle.
I wanted that we could touch up on some local stuff. What's going on in the 504?
Yeah, man.
And the local sports and local what's going sport. On with the kids.
For real, yeah. I could jump on that right quick. I know we're in this AAU travel ball circuit stuff right now with the basketball. We're going, you know, we got to bring up the Carver kids again, man. The big boy Solomon, Dorian. You know, they got a few more, but I know we've been seeing it.
Solomon been getting a whole lot of more offers playing with the Team Thad.
Team Thad in the tournament.
And I saw, you know, it's like
I seen he got 5 offers, man. Shout out to Solomon.
Yeah,
shout out to Solomon.
LSU, some Creighton, big boy schools. Creighton,
I saw that.
Some, you know, I think Houston had already offered them. I'm not sure, but I like to see all that, man. That they getting this good recruiting from right down here in New Orleans. And I got to see him play at the Grind. What Apollo got going on with
that boy's a beast, man. It's solid.
It's like a little.
I'm trying to let you guys know what colleges offered them.
Yeah, man. So just check them out. They got a lot of talent, man, in New Orleans, buddy. These guys are getting recruited, going to D1 colleges. NAIA colleges, D2s, you know. I feel like we're on an up and up with recruiting and basketball
For sure, basketball is on the rise in the city, look like.
You know, and I was always told, and it seems like it, that, you know, Louisiana, we are football, you know. A lot of football, you know, recruits down here. That's what we known for, Louisiana, period. We got a lot of good football players going to be coming from the South, especially down here, Florida, Fast Boys. Louisiana got a lot of NFL players, you know. But basketball, it seemed like we got some good things going on with recruiting and these coaches getting out there, getting these kids looked at, getting them in front of these college coaches, you know, and getting them places, man. You know, a scholarship, you know, wherever you're going, bro.
Experience
college, you know, get the reality of it, you know, shoot for your dreams, but no, basketball, you know, it ends for everybody one day, you know. So a scholarship. You may play just as long as Kyrie Irving, but it might be overseas or something, you know? Or you might play just as long as Isaiah Ryder, you know? 4 or 5 years right here in college, 2 years somewhere, you know? Go experience college, man.
Shout out to Carver, man. Carver doing big things, bro.
Yeah, bro.
Carver look like they building that powerhouse back strong.
I can't wait to see them dudes this year, buddy.
Carver gonna be good for the next 10 years, bro. If dude keep doing what he doing, Carver chasing chips. They gave one up last year. Carver chasing chips, baby. Carver chasing chips. Because they young talent. When Dorian and Solomon leave, these young boys that's handling that pill right now, Fum still gonna be that. Them freshmen and them sophomores good at Carver. Right now, and they ain't getting nothing but taller.
When I was at the Grind.
Like the little dude, Jalen Hicks, I think he a freshman. He's 6'5", he's a 6'5" guard, Jalen Hicks.
Let me see.
He put on the show for NYBL basketball. Jalen Hicks, he class of 2023. That means he's a freshman right now. Jalen Hicks.
All right, I don't know if I saw him before.
Watch out for him.
Yeah,
he's another. He a good one on Carver team. He young. Yeah, we're speaking young. On the.
And I saw some. They pointing out some dudes who supposed to be going there. I said, man, Carver about to reload. I think Paulo was showing me some cats he thought was going to Carver or something.
Oh, okay.
For high school, man.
But you know, last week Solomon picked up the offer from LSU, Alabama, Louisiana Tech, and Dorian picked up an offer from the University of Houston. That's big, which they have New Orleans ties.
Aquinas White, Hollis Price.
Hollis Price. All them on the team.
With Coach Calvin Sampson.
Deacon coming back next year for his Deacon, I think he coming back. I think
Deacon was a senior, man.
Yeah, if you get a free, this was a free year. Everybody,
man, no.
Everybody can.
That's
come.
The rule.
Everybody can come back,
man. No, indeed,
pull
man.
It up now.
That's crazy.
Everybody can come back. Everybody was a free.
I didn't know that.
It was a free year. Everybody can come back. Cause they ain't really play whole seasons. It wasn't really.
So
everybody's eligible for a new year.
So the whoever played game this is year, crazy. Then he got the transfer report. It's crazy.
Everybody's
right now.
Eligible for a new year. That so last year was a free year.
If seniors get to play again,
yeah,
that means you have a whole lot of freshmen who may not touch the flow.
Right.
Creighton, it's hard to put a 50-year senior, a 23-year-old playing an 18-year-old who real good. Now, a 23-year-old who been playing ball hard, say he's not a superstar NBA player against an 18-year-old NBA player. Man, that dude could ball with that 18-year-old potential NBA player. I'm 23, know how to play. Maybe a little bit less talented than you, but I should have a mind. You ain't gonna touch the flow. What's gonna happen with the freshmen?
Right.
Some of them gonna be able to take some spots.
Right. Some of them gonna be able to take
But
some
somebody's
spots.
Moving out. Yeah. You're talking about the senior coming back. Who started already. That's the hardest job to get.
Right.
For real, like did MJ come and start at North Carolina's freshman year?
No. Fuck was, no.
Yeah, Sam, Kenneth Smith,
no,
them.
Fuck no. Sam Perkins and fucking, come on, man. Big Game James, man. Worthy.
James Worthy, yeah.
That's, I can't that's think who was the man.
You know, because I know.
But, I want to say Sam Perkins was the man. But Big James Worthy turned
Smith,
out to be
though?
The better.
I think Kenny Smith's start was a year ahead of him, I think.
No, Kenny Smith was on the Kenny Smith was, I think, under him. I think Kenny Smith was on the team when he hit the shot. I mean, no. Kenny Smith wasn't on the team yet when he hit the shot. Against Patrick Ewing up against Georgetown in the Superdome when they won the championship.
That was MJ sophomore year.
Kenny wasn't up. I think the next year, Kenny Mabel was there if he played with him. He was there that year. Mike, no man, go to the championship that next year. Because Word and Perkins was gone to the league.
I can't remember. I may be wrong with Kenny Smith. I think somebody. But saying that to see, that's a good comparison with what's gonna go on is if senior players
free
get
year.
To stay back.
Free year.
What? You know how much better they feel like they gonna look to get that draft pick, to get drafted, or all right, they got me a how many rounds they going NBA? They don't go too many of them. Three rounds
to get to the finals.
No. I'm talking about draft rounds.
Hold up. Not NBA rounds? Oh. Two.
It's two.
There's
no third round.
Ain't no third round in NBA. It's two, then free agency.
Yeah. That's tough. Yeah. That's 60 players, 62 players, 64 players, whatever. Damn. Whew.
Yeah.
Yeah, I wonder what you'll do. I wonder if you may have, how'd they go? Can they see their options on overseas if people won't come, you know, if they could go pro? I think they could do that. I think that's probably the talking to an agent part that they letting you do, and then you can come back if you don't feel like you
right, yeah.
in a position.
Because that's
won't
what
Deacon
did last year. They loosened up on some of the rules. Like you could you can't get an agent though, but you could go test the NBA waters. You could do, if you don't hire an agent, you could do anything. You could go talk to NBA teams. You could go work out for them, see if they like you and everything. But once you get an agent, then not your eligibility gone. But it used to be, even if you go fuck with that, it's there, your eligibility hit. But no, now you could really go work out. So some of them dudes was going to test the NBA waters and they seen they wasn't ready and they went back to college. You know what I'm saying? I think, I won't say somebody played in the summer league and everything and then went back to college. Mm. Or some shit. Yeah, I think one of them played like in the summer league or something and didn't go. Some worked out, some you could go test the NBA waters. Cause remember last year Deacon did it.
Yeah, I know you can do it. Something like you can, it's something like that where you don't hire an agent, you can go.
Lamar went played in that stuff with the NBA when he tested it and then went back to, cause remember before he left, saying he was into the draft. But then he went back for his junior year.
Yeah.
After his sophomore year, he had entered the draft little thing. But he wound up going back to Mississippi State. So it's some kind of way that you can test the NBA waters, but you can still go back to college. But I know one of the stipulations is you can't have an agent. You know what I'm saying? But on this local recruiting, just shout out to all the local guys around the city that's getting all these offers, man. I haven't seen this much spotlight on New Orleans talent since I've been watching it.
I see the dudes at Landry Walker. I see they just got some scholarships or just signed to some.
Yeah, Warren Easton. Loading them up over there. Warren Easton loading them up over there. Every day I click my phone, I see these guys from Warren Easton getting offers.
We know this football. I feel like we lit football in the city, you know.
Yeah, they have this guy.
Kids going everywhere.
Yeah, they going everywhere.
Literally, they going everywhere, you know.
And I'm so happy for New Orleans, you know, on that level, because I feel like it been here, but they just wouldn't come here. But the few players that did get away from here and was able to show the world, put the spotlight on it, like, oh, y'all need to go through that. You know what I'm saying? So now, it's like, I be happy because every Saturday and Sunday, I'm watching that N.O. come across that screen. Point blank for period. Sure. But this where I start from, the recruiting, you know what I'm saying? You know, it start from when they're in high school. I know a lot of you guys, y'all be at the house and y'all be watching them NBA games, them NFL games. But, you know, don't forget where y'all come from. Don't forget about them high school games and them park ball games and stuff like that. Because that be the best games. Hmm. The best games I done been to. We been having season tickets at the Superdome. Ain't none of I done been to the Superdome. Me and my family been having season tickets all my life. But the best game I been to ain't never been in the Superdome. You know? Most of the best games I've been to have been right at City Park, Tag Army Stadium, somewhere right down here in New Orleans, standing room only, with the band playing, man. You in the stands. You know, you see you see people you haven't seen in years. You know, just all type of little things, man. Y'all need to start checking out that high school scene a little bit more. You know what I'm saying?
Yep.
It'd be good ball. Like Carr and Easton right now, that's a good rivalry in New Orleans right now. Two powerhouses. I mean, we were so happy, you know, we would wish, when I was in school, all we could do is wish if we can make it to the Dome. Warren Easton and Carr made it to the Dome and played each other 2 years in a row. That's incredible. In New Orleans, in the Dome, in the same district. They met in the championship 2 years ago. Shout out to Easton and Carr. You know what I'm saying? Keep it going. And it looked like they're going to meet again. Like, they're favored to meet again. That's crazy. Mm-hmm. Like, McMahon and Carver penciled in to meet again. They penciled in to meet again. They're going to be 1-2 on Foy. You know?
Yep.
Now, only way they don't make them favorite to repeat again is if everybody go back in there together. If they put the Catholic schools back there in there with them. Then, you know, St. Thomas More Evangel and them going to have something to stick. But far as the public school bracket that they in right now, it's called Eastern and Neville. Everybody else, get your mind right. Call Eastern and Neville, baby. Everybody else on Foyer, y'all got to get y'all stuff together. Y'all chasing them three right now. That's the three-headed monster right there. Call one Eastern and Neville, you know. Eastern, y'all still chasing y'all a chip.
How Carver looking on the football this year? I know that they was doing their thing. I know they was, you know, players away from being.
Man, Carver, bro, football, hate to say it, bro, it's going to be a while.
L Page gone?
Yeah, L Page at Kennedy, head coach. It's going to be a while with Carver.
Talking about the kid, though, who was the one on the field just now?
Yeah, Southeastern.
Yes,
he gone already. He went in January as an early enrollee.
Okay, all right.
He went in January. Shout out to the nervous graduating, right, finishing early. Right. That was a big shocker to me when I went on his page and saw him. He was already in college already. I'm like, dang, I didn't know the nervous was already in college already. So he was an early enrollee. That's what's up. But Carver not looking too good on the football level. They just lost Kyrie Coleman. He was the Big 12 freshman, defensive freshman of the year. DN for TCU starting as a true freshman. 11 sacks or something. True freshman. They lost him before this year. They lost their quarterback, Quincy. You know, they Carver rebuilding. They gonna, one thing you can't count Carver out, because we know one thing in that night walk, Talon gonna walk through that door.
Yeah.
Talon is gonna walk through that door. That's the night walk.
I'm saying, so yeah.
That's the night walk.
It's no known. You don't know what they got right now.
You don't know what they have right now, but you have to respect. Because
they're young and they done lost some good players.
You know, you have to respect Carver, because Talon gonna walk through that door.
For sure, for sure.
You know what
football
I'm saying?
Football and basketball, for sure.
But I was trying to get you out there, bro. Hopefully, y'all, I can get CD out there to a game this year. He be busy with the girls and all that. He missed the game of the decade when Lance didn't get in. To me, you know, in the last 10 years, I haven't seen a game like that yet. Cub beat Warren Easton by 1 point. Some say Lance got in, some say he didn't.
All right, the
Warren Easton went for the win.
Yeah,
you know what I'm saying? They went on to meet each other again in the championship. But the real championship game was the one during the regular season for the district title on the Thursday night, 28-27. Warren Easton went for the win. Warren Easton did the QB blast. That little dude came through there and blew it up. Warren Easton cried out there that night. I told a friend of mine, he was sitting next to me. I told him, I said, yeah, bro, this you looking at the championship right now. I said, ain't nobody going to stop. Once she wanted Easton crying out there, they want them people again. Everybody else in trouble. You know what I'm saying? Warren Easton went on the roll after that, beating everybody by 25 points all the way. You know? Shout out to Warren Easton. Shout out to Warren Easton coaching. Everybody give y'all a hard time. You know, y'all haven't beat Carr yet. You know, but they don't understand. You know, Carr was y'all first.
Right.
Carr was Warren Easton first. Yeah. Carr couldn't beat Neville every time. Everybody laughing at how Warren Easton can't beat Carr. But if you go look at the beginning of the Carr era, they couldn't beat Neville the same way. Losing to him by 1 point and shit. Mm-hmm. Warren Easton, all y'all got to do is keep coming, Warren Easton. That's what Carr did. Carr just kept coming. Carr was losing first, getting to the dome, losing to Franklinton, getting to the dome, going for two when the boy Tonka could have walked in. Tonka handed the ball off, I want to say, and would have walked in the end zone or something. He tried to keep it, and he could have. That was, I'm going to tell you who beat him in the dome, McGee. Remember McGee, who was toting that thing for LSU? Yeah. Terrence McGee?
Yeah.
Yeah, he was the quarterback for Franklin. He beat him in the dome. But shout out to all the schools around the city, man. Especially
quick history right quick again.
Yeah, I'm always giving y'all history. Yeah, but y'all need to go out there and check out that high school football, man. Don't forget about that. Mostly we're going to give y'all that probably at the end of every show. We probably going to tap in on some local stuff. We really didn't tap in on local stuff tonight. I'm going to go back in the lab and look at some stuff. This time I have some real local info for y'all.
Yeah, next week. Off season, recruiting.
Yeah.
Just our thoughts. Ain't nothing really going on, so to see how things going. But right now they got the grind going on with Coach Paulo and with Fast Basketball Academy. They got a good thing going on with this high school thing, bro. Some good pickup games. Some good talent out there, bro. The city got some talent. And it's good with the local scene with the basketball. We already know what football gonna bring. We gonna try to touch it a little more, but football
talent is
there every year. It's just going down every year in New Orleans. You know, pretty sure we up there with the best citywide football divisions in the country. Like, got to be. I'm pretty sure if we with our radius of schools, we probably could go wherever and be with the best of schools in the same size-wise.
For sure, and I feel like we have to start doing that, too. Our schools down here, we have to start scheduling. Like we doing football, we have to start going to them other places and playing basketball games. Like the public school, like Carver. Man, get with somebody and put them on y'all schedule. Get some sponsors to pay for that trip, man. Get a few sponsors to put in $1,000 a piece for this trip, man. We won't go play Catholic High in Philadelphia or something. We won't go on that East Coast and see what we working with.
Yeah.
We won't go to Indiana, basketball country. We won't go to Indiana and play a public school out there and see what they're working with. Just, you know, instead of not Houston and all that, I'm talking about go somewhere. It's in this new world, man. Flights and stuff so cheap now. It's easier to travel now, man.
And I feel like these schools, man. These kids got all the talent in the world, man. That's what it's about. We can experience more college things in high school now. They could on the sports level and on every level, you know. But that's it. They need to be getting out more. Yeah, man. Go ahead. We going West Coast. Go East Coast. Playing some tournaments, man.
Exactly. When it's tournament time, these Christmas tournaments and all that, we trying to go get in that out of town.
Yeah.
We trying to go to Chicago, Illinois, and see what, you know. Oh, that's basketball country. You don't know if you good. You got to go to these tournaments in Las Vegas and, you know. Yeah. Instead of just always running to Atlanta, Texas, Alabama, Tennessee. No, you know, all that's cool, all that's close. But really, that's football country. They threw that because they know they got to come through the South. They know the South just have athletes. They're going to come through here. But if you want to go dive in the pool, in the basketball pool, yeah, man, you want to go on that East Coast or you want to go in that Midwest?
Yeah, that's cool.
It's in the gym. Yeah, you want to go to the Midwest or the East Coast. That's where the dominant basketball players are.
And the outside playing ball, too.
Yeah, man. You know, my people told me they went to Indiana one time, man. Literally, wherever you go, a basketball goal, every house got the court. It's real out there. Basketball. It is it in Indiana. Go out there, man. Do tournaments. You know, Indianapolis. I think we went to Indy one time. Wichita, Kansas, or something like that.
I've been to Kansas, Wichita.
Wichita, when they had the big tournament, nigga went out there. Yeah,
that's where Biddy Nationals was at. Yeah, we won Biddy Nationals out there, DG.
That's when y'all went 45 and 0, huh?
Yeah.
44. 44 and 0. You in Perth now, man.
Yeah. DG, man. Glenn Hosey. Damn. Can't even think who's on that team.
But yeah, y'all, appreciate y'all for tuning in, whoever tuned in.
You dig.
We'll see y'all next week.
You heard me? You ain't got nothing crazy to say, bro?
Oh, what something you crazy.
Know, what you, I forgot. You said, what you
we got? We laid back today, as y'all can see.
Super Bowl pick. Who your Super Bowl pick? Super Bowl pick, right?
I think I said it on the first show, but my Super Bowl pick right now, since we spoke on the schedule.
Yeah, early, just an early. Come on now, draft.
It's on wax right now. Yeah. The Rams.
He got the Rams, baby.
Stafford, league
Stafford,
MVP.
Stafford, Rams. That's his bold prediction right there.
Listen, you just gave the Rams. You just gave the Rams 21 points a game. Are you 24 points a game? You just gave the Rams Patrick Mahomes.
Ooh.
You just gave the Rams Mahomes, man.
Man, we just gotta, you know. This man go with the Rams, bro, so he went out the box. But in the good box though, Rams got everything.
Aaron Donald coming, and I'm shutting down half of the field, and I'm getting my quarterback the ball. And they say I got the smartest offensive mind in the game, not calling my plays for me. Where Robert Woods and Deshaun Jackson are running across this field. See, it's gonna be hard to beat. When they can stop you from scoring, and you know, put it like this. I'm gonna get three at least every time we get the ball, Stafford. We gonna get three at least. Right. Like how we feel about the Saints in Seattle and
my
shit.
My early pick.
Gonna get three at least. That's how I feel about Stafford. Gonna get three at least.
Man, look. My early pick, I'm gonna go with the Chiefs, bro. My homeboy.
My homeboy in the building.